again we may say Ritu Dweep. Yesterday also when we went, Maharaj said that we are in Radhakund. Ritu Dweep. Ritu Dweep is a I think all of you may come to this side who are in the rear. Hare Krishna. Because the speaker is over there, you can hear that side very well. Those who will be in the front line may be able to hear. If you are listening here, okay, otherwise you go to.
But Sri Sampradaya is here.
Eh?
Sri Sampradaya.
Sri Sampradaya is here.
Sri Sampradaya, you know?
Commencing from Lakshmi. Yeah.
That taken off place.
Lakshmi.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes.
If you want to hear more, you can come this side because here is what?
Speaker.
Speaker is there. Easily it can be heard from there.
You should sit there.
Yes.
So, Hare Krishna.
Not so loud.
This place, when we went, again it may be called that Ritu Dweep and Radhakund. In fact, we went to other side of Radhakund. Yesterday we could not have a glance of Radhakund, but today we were just at the bank of Radhakund. It was the another side of Radhakund. Yesterday we went this side. Maharaj was telling also that the name of this place is Kobla. But in fact, it is distorted name of, earlier its name was Kobala. Kobala means witch girl. This place is of Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu is having a girl inside. Witch girl. Ko means who. Ko means witch. And Bala means a girl. So Kobala means witch girl. That is Radha Rani. She is inside Mahaprabhu. The name of that village is Kobala. Maharaj started with a prayer of Prabodhananda Saraswati, and it said, what to speak of Radhaji? Even the maid servant of Radhaji so much potent that Krishna is doing menial request at their lotus feet, that please let me have an opportunity to meet Radharani. Such is the highest position of maid servant of Radharani, and that Radharani is having a kund that is called Radha Kund. If I become fortunate enough, that may become a small slice of the broom of that place, the broom which cleans that place, I will be fortunate. Maharaj also recited another shlok, probably it was from Radha Sudharas Nidhi. It said that when Radharani has kataksh on Krishna, Krishna shivers his crown of his flute falls down, his mor mukut falls down, his pitambar slips down and he doesn't have his own control over himself. So this is the highest position of Radharani. And we were sitting in place Radha Kund, which is the Kund of Radharani.
What you understand by this? The poet, Prabodhananda Saraswati, is praying that I want to be a stick of that kunj in a broom. I will think that if I am a stick of that broom, and it is broomed in the kunj of Srimati Radhika, then I will think that my life is successful. Why? Because Krishna is praying and praying to the maidservants of Srimati Radhika, Palya Dashi of Radhika, that please let me go to Srimati Radhika. And they are telling, you cannot go. You are big cheater, you are lawyer, you are dhurta and all these things. So we will not permit you to go there. And Krishna again and again is falling down on the feet of that gopi. So how glorious is Srimati Radhika? So in divine service of Krishna, the gopis are prominent. So I don't want that after my bhajan sadhan. Bhajan sadhan. I will serve Krishna. I don't want that. But I want that I should be maid servant of Srimati Radhika. So Srila Raghunath Das Goswami has told. What he has told? He told that, telling that, Otakire, no jivami to agni.
Tavai vasmi,
na jivami to agni. Iti bigyaya rade, tong nai mam charananti. Srila Raghunath Das Goswami is praying, or Srimati Radhike, I want to serve only you. Please accept me. And if you are not accepting me, then I will die. So this is in the line of Srila Rupa Goswami. So this mood is prominent in Rupanuga Vaishnava. If this mood is not there, then we are not Rupanuga. What is, we tell that my guru is Rupanuga. Rupanu Guru Varga ki jai, we do. Why Rupanu? What is Rupanu? We should try to know the what is Rupanuga. What is Rupanuga? Rupa Goswami has made Bhakti Goswami Sindhu Ujjalin Mani. And he has showed how bhakti becomes rush. He has given all things which has never been explained before. But what was his own mood? This is Rupanuga. If anyone is serving Krishna in Dasyaras, Sakharas, Vasalyaras, it is so good. Also by Swakiya Bhava, it is so good. But it is not Rupanuga, it is Raganuga. But when we will follow the mood of Srimati Rupa Goswami, how he served Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, how he served Srimati Radhika and conjugal, this very mood those who are falling, they are called Rupani. If anyone only following Vaidhi Bhakti always and preaching, he is not Rupanuga. Vallabhacharya is not Rupanuga. Ramanuji is not Rupanuga. Their highest topic, top of bhakti, but yet they are not Rupanuga. Raganuga also. Vallabhacharya is Raganuga, but not Rupanuga. So, our whole acharyas have accepted this, that what was the mood of Rupa Goswami, internally and externally, they are called Rupanuga. So we should try to know what is Rupanuga, what is Raganuga, what is Bhakti, what is Vaidhi Bhakti, what is Raganuga Bhakti, everything. We should try to chant Hari name. And after that, hearing Chaitanya Charitamrita and all these things, especially coming in Navadvip, we'll have to know what was the mood of Rupa Goswami. What was the mood of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur? What was the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when he was here? Then we can know all these things. So I told so many things there, he is now describing. If you are not understanding, you can ask again. If you are not understanding and any doubt, you can ask.
महाराज वहाँ मैंने सब इसका अनुवाद कर चुका हूँ जो आपने बोला था राधा कुंड वाला
He has told about Radha Kund. Now I want that he should explain of
विद्यानगर का
विद्यानगर छोड़ दीजिए
वो क्या कहते हैं माम गाछ We went to Mamgachi, really densely green area. Maharaj told its name is Modrum Dweep. And Drum means a tree, but Drum means tree. Maharaj is explaining very huge tree. And Mod means which gives pleasure.
What tree? Banyan tree.
Drum means tree of banyan, and there was very huge tree of banyan, and mod means to give pleasure, because that tree gave pleasure to Mahaprabhu, so its name is Mod Drum Dweep. Maharaj also explained that once when Lord Ram was in exile for 14 years, at that time Ram, Lakshman and Sitaji, they were staying at that place. Maharaj was explaining that Ram started smiling with meaningful smile, and he was having some thoughts in his heart. Sitaji just asked that why are you smiling? What are you thinking? At that time, Lord Ram told Sitaji that today we are having this leela, but sometime after I will come and perform another leela. I will come in a very beautiful form here as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Maharaj explained that he said, at that time you will be my wife and I will take sannyas and I will leave you. Then Sitaji asked, why did you leave me? What the fault I have committed that you will give up me? Maharaj was explaining that Lord Ram told to Sitaji, see, this time, just after some time now, Ravan will come and will steal you. But I will at that time hide you. I will give you to Agnidev to protect you. And that way we have separation. And later on also, when I will do reign over Ayodhya, in the end I will give up you. And I will send you to jungles. You will go to Valmiki's ashram and you will stay there. This time, every time, I will leave you and you will go away from me. But at that time, I will do reverse. At that time, I will leave you and go in different jungles and you will stay at home. So, Maharaj was explaining, this was the Leela, this Leela will be performed over there. But why you will leave? This time, I will leave you and go in jungles. That time, you will leave me and go in jungles. But why to leave? Why you want to leave? Then Maharaj was saying the potency of Prem. Prem has got two main major factors. One is Sambhog and one is Vipralamba. So, Vipralamba is a factor which in fact support and glorify Milan, meeting. Vipralamba means separation. Separation is plays very important and vital role in to intensify the enjoyment and love pleasure of meeting. Maharaj was explaining that how I will enjoy the mood of separation. He explained that once Ram was performing a yajna. In that yajna, his sons, Lav Kush, Ram did not know that they are his son. They came and they started reciting Ramayana. And they started reciting Ramayana in such a melodious and pathetic voice that everyone was thrilled and started weeping. Ram was moved. He was very much pleased with those boys. He asked Lakshman, go and ask them.
Also all began to weep.
Everyone was weeping there. Everyone was full of tears.
Mothers. All brothers,
Ram's brothers, Ram's mother were weeping. The way pathetically and melodiously they were reciting Ramayana. Ramayana which they learned from Valmiki.
And what are the subject? Ram, Lakshman, Sita,
Vanvas
was that.
I see. In that recitation, they were reciting the Leela of Ram leaving to exile. And at that time, what was the scene of separation, pathetic scene they were reciting in their recitation. Everyone weeping. And then Ram asked Lakshman that go and ask these boys that whose son are they, where do they live, and give them lot of presents of jewels. So Lakshman went there to them and he asked, oh dear boys, who is your father? Those boys says, it appears you are quite learned, but you don't know even a small thing that from brahmacharis you are not supposed to ask identification by their father. You have to ask.
At that time, when they were singing in the council of Ram, all were moved. Kausalya, Kaikeyi and all others were seeing that the face of Ram is quite same as Lav and Kush, resembling both mouth faces like same. So they are thinking in their heart that if Ram has a son, he must be like these sons. And thinking, they were all weeping that Ram has sent Sita in jungle and he has no wife, no children, nothing. But they were somewhat thinking, anyhow, when Sita was in Ayodhya and Ram was ordering her to go to send his
her
to jungle. At that she was pregnant there in Ayodhya. So they are guessing that it may be anyhow that the two boys are son of Ram. But they are not declaring this, but guessing somewhat. Then?
Guessing.
Then these boys said, our identification is through our guru, not through our father.
What?
Okay. Yeah, everyone is hearing, I think. Then Lakshman became ashamed. He said, okay, I committed a mistake. Tell who are your guru. I am son of, we are disciple of Balmiki, Rishi Balmiki, and
you have cleared it.
When Ram moved and told Lakhan that go to these boys and ask that what is the name of his father and where they live and from where they have come. What is the name of her mother, their mother? And also asked that we are so much happy to hear their songs that we want to donate him something. So a pot of golden pot, very big, so much golden coins were kept, so many golden
jewels
and jewels, ornaments were there. So good cloths were there. And Lakhan went with all these things to two boys and asked, what is the name of your father? What is the name of your mother? Where do you live? And we want to present you. Then what?
So when they when Lakshman presented so much valuables to them, they said, look, we are brahmacharis. We live in ashram of Balmiki, which is full of many trees of different fruits. We eat those fruits, and nearby the river is flowing. Whenever we need, we take water of it. We even don't need a pot. What to speak of these jewels? What will we do of these jewels? We don't need it. We are brahmachari only. I think you should give it to someone else who is needy for them. So again Lakshman was ashamed. And then they went away to their mother. Sita ji was very much worried because her sons were getting late. She was coming out and in her house and waiting for them. When they reached there, Sita ji was inquiring with anxiety, where had you been? Why are you so late? So they said, mother, today Lord Ram is performing very big yajna. We went there and we recited Ramayana over there. And mother, when we were reciting and the scene of Ram's departure to exile to jungle, everyone was weeping. And the most important thing which we saw, that Lord Ram was sitting there and beside him there was a very beautiful golden lady sitting with him, and the complexion, the form and the beauty of that lady was exactly similar to you. It appeared as if you were sitting. If it would have spoken, it would appear as if you were sitting over there. The way they narrated it, Sita ji could gather what is happening there. Sita ji realized that Ram did not get any another marriage.
Began to weep bitterly.
And she started weeping. She said, oh, Ram loves me so much. Ram has not given up Sita. It is king who has given up queen because of his kingdom and because of his rules over there. So she was very much moved. Maharaj was explaining, this is called the separation, Vipralamba Bhav, pleasure in Vipralamba Bhav, which really gives pleasure. So for that pleasure, Lord performs this Leela. Then Maharaj said, similarly, in Krishna Leela also.
When Sita was weeping, both Lavkush and Lav and Kush, they began to pacify her. They began to pacify and they wept their tear with their claws. Mother, why you are weeping? But Sita cannot tell that Rama is my husband and he has left me for whole life, but weeping and weeping. Sita is thinking that Ram has not left me. He has left his queen. If he has left me, how he should worship? He is worshipping my deity there. Ram, when Sita was given to jungle, Sita was so in separation mode, always weeping. But at that time, she used to talk with his two sons, and also sometimes Valmiki used to come to Sita and to satisfy him by his sweet words, Harikatha. And Sita was with so many women sadhu, always surrounded by them. So her separation was divided here and there. But Ram was alone in the big palace, always sleeping on the mat on earth. Sita has some sleep, but Ram has no sleep. None was to help Ram. So Ram was feeling more separation than Sita. In same way, in Krishna Leela,
So Maharaj explained similarly, in Krishna Leela, when Krishna went to Dwarka, at that time gopis were feeling mood of separation, but they were getting together, they were disclosing their heart pain to each other, and that way they were sharing their pain to each other, and their separation pain was distributed and hence reduced. But Krishna in Dwarka, he was feeling intense separation pain in his heart, but he was unable to share it with anyone, and he was sharing it alone. So Maharaj was saying that intensity of separation pain with Ram and Krishna is far more than what is in gopis and Sitaji's, because gopis also could share it with their friends. All gopis were sharing it, and Sitaji also could have chance of having their pain shared to her son and others. Then Maharaj wanted to explain, but very slightly he told that how Vishnupriya was also feeling separation.
That Sita became Vishnupriya.
Because the same in this Leela, same Sita became Vishnupriya and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was Ram.
So Mahaprabhu wanted to repay Sita. That is why
so
having a deity there.
Yeah, golden deity.
Yes.
So Maharaj explained there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was reciprocating. The mood of separation is tasted, but here Chaitanya Mahaprabhu left, and at that time Vishnupriya was having golden deity of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and feeling separation and chanting, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went jungles and feeling mood of separation. And in the Leela of Ram, Sitaji went outside and she was feeling mood of separation. The intensity of separation which Ram had now here, Vishnupriya is having the same intensity. Now she is inside her home and always thinking about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. As in case of Ram, Ram had golden statue of Sita and worshipping Sita, and now Vishnupriya was having golden deity of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and worshipping Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and chanting Hare Krishna, taking one piece of this rice and just collecting whatever the piece of rice she could collect that she used to cook, then she used to offer.
Washing with her tears.
Washing with her tears. She will pick up one piece of rice, chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, wash it with her tears, and whatever rice she will collect this way in the whole day, she will cook them, then will offer it to Mahaprabhu, and then she will give it to her mother. Whatever will be left, then she used to take that much only. Maharaj told one thing, which is to be underlined after this whole thing, that it does not mean that we are advocating or professing the mood of separation. Vipralamba is not the main mood. Main mood is meeting, milan. But Vipralamba gives meeting more intensified. The word I wrote in Hindi, milan ki utkarshta ke liye vireh hai. So,
when there is no separation mood,
there is no
nothing is there. So in sadhan, if a sadhak is not feeling separation for Krishna or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when Krishna will meet, when I may serve Krishna, then he is actually no sadhak. So our sadhana is to feeling separation first. Like in Purvarag, there is more separation. So for sadhak, this is like Purvarag. We have no Purvarag. But hearing Hari Katha from Vaishnavas, reading Chaitanya Charitamrita, Srimad Bhagavatam, a greed will come, may come, and then we will have a separation that when we will be able to serve Krishna. Where is Krishna? Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, where is Krishna? Weeping always. We have seen six Goswami, Rup, Sanatan, Raghunath, Ji Goswami and all others. Sankhya Purvakanam Gan Nativi, Kalavasani Kritau, Nidrahar Bihar Ad Vijitau, Chatant Dino Chujau, Radha Krishna Gurasmate, Madhuriman Dain Sammohitau, Bande Rup Sanatan Rajagau Sri Jivago. He Radhe, Brijadevi Ke Chalalite, He Nanda Suno Kuta, Sri Govardhan Kalpapada Patale, Kalindi Bane Kuta, Bhushantavi Sarvato Kedai, Mahabihvalau Bande Rup Sanatano Rujugau Siji. If this mood is not coming, that O Krishna, where you are? O Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, where you are? O Gurudev, where you are? O Rup Sanatan, where you are? O Sarup Namodar, where you are? Yes, I want your darshan, I want your service. If this mood is not coming, then sadhana is not sadhana. So, to feel separation from Krishna or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is sadhana. And when we will weep, rolling down here, there, where Krishna you are, where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, oh Nityananda Prabhu, then this is sadhana. By this their heart will be melted and they will bestow their mercies upon us. So this is called sadhana. So we should try to feel that we have left Krishna, we have forgotten Krishna, we have forgotten Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Without his service, we cannot be happy in our life. So we should weep like them, like Raghunath Das Goswami. Always chanting not less than 1 lakh Harinam, doing pranam to about 1,000 of Vaishnavas, doing pranam to 1,000 places of Krishna pastime and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu pastime. Like this, weeping here, there, sometimes in Radhakund, sometimes in Vrindavan, sometimes in Bhandirvan, sometimes in Nandagaon, Varsana. We have seen that everywhere the bhajan kuti of Rupa Sanatan and all others are there. Everyone. So we should do bhajan like that. Giving up all things, we should be try to be akinchan and niskinchan. Anyhow, passing our days by anything taking, not giving impression on that thing, ornaments, better clothes, living mood so high, like Rupa Sanatan Vishi Yakan Bhajan, or even Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Srila Prabhupada, our Gurudev, then we can do bhajan. They have no time to criticize anyone. They have no time to eat and drink and to sit and to sleep. Sometimes Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, taking rest only for 1 hour, sometimes half an hour, sometimes nothing. Eating, sometimes dry gram. Gram, chanato. Sometimes. Sometimes nothing. Whole night weeping, 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 weeping. Sometimes writing poems, writing books, always immersed in moods. So we should try to follow all these things and try to develop our Krishna consciousness.
सारंग की कथा सुनाई महाराज आल्सो एक्सप्लेन्ड दैट इन मामगाछी देयर वाज अ टेंपल एंड डीटी वाज बीइंग वर्शिप्ड बाय वन ऑफ द पार्षद ऑफ चैतन्य महाप्रभु हिज नेम वाज सारंग वंस महाप्रभु केम टू हिम सारंग बिकेम क्वाइट ओल्ड ही सेड यू हैव बिकम सो ओल्ड व्हाई डोंट यू अडॉप्ट यू हैव अ वन डिसिपल He said, oh no, I am not fit to make any disciple. I will not make any disciple. He said, well, if you will... And I don't find any person qualified enough that I should have a disciple. Mahaprabhu told that, you know, you are becoming old. You will not be able to serve your deity so well. And who will serve your deity when you will become very old? And if you say that you don't get a qualified disciple, I give you one instruction. Tomorrow you go and see any person. First time in your day morning, you give initiation to him.
Wait, you see first?
Whoever you see first, you give initiation. He said, okay. Then he went to Ganges early in the morning at about 4:30 a.m. to take bath. And when he was taking bath, he found a dead body was coming there. It was the body of a very young boy of hardly 13, 14 years age. And when he saw him, he was very much perplexed. He said, oh, Mahaprabhu told me to give initiation to a person whoever you see first. And I am seeing this person. He is a dead person. What should I do? He said, well, I should follow the instruction of Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu has said me that you give initiation, so I should give him initiation. And Mahaprabhu, and he took that dead body and gave him Gopal Mantra, Mahamantra in his ear. The moment he gave Gopal Mantra and Mahamantra in his ear, that boy, he just sat up and he became conscious and he became alive. It was really a miraculous news to whole village, and this news spreaded everywhere. And this boy got alive, this news went to the village of this boy, which was nearby village, and his parents came. They say, "Oh, my son, you are alive now. You are so fortunate. Please come with us." So you come with us. He said, "Oh, mother, father, I died for you. A serpent just cut me. What is it called? Bit me, and because of poison, I died. You threw my body to the Ganges. You have already surrendered it to Ganges. For you people, I am already a dead boy. So now my life has come because of my Gurudev. So I will now serve my Gurudev for the rest of my life, because this life owes to him. So please don't mind, I cannot come with you." And since then he started living with Sarang. His name was Murari. His name was Murari.
That boy named Murari.
Sarang kept the name of that boy Murari. Sarang Murari. That place, worshipping place, is famous as Sarang Murari.
There is a very big tree, banyan tree. There, even where Sarang Murari was worshipping Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, there is a big banyan tree, very, very big. And still, there lives a very big serpent there. Very big serpent. But it never bites anyone. And even Sarang Murari's worshipped deity is there. When we reached there, another party came there, we could not go there. But very nearer to our place, this place is there. So even today, Sarang Murari and his deity is worshipped today also. Also, I told there about Vrindavan Das. You should tell.
That was also birthplace of Vrindavan Das. Vrindavan Das is... So Maharaj explained that place is also birthplace of Vrindavan Das. He has written one very important script. Maharaj also explained that this place was birthplace of Vrindavan, Thakur Vrindavan Das. He was son of Narayani, and he wrote one scripture.
Who was Narayani?
Narayani was
the nephew of
Srivas
Pandit.
Niece of Srivas Pandit, and in her very young age, she got mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
She used to eat remnants of Mahaprabhu daily.
She was very, very dear to Mahaprabhu. So
he was married to this place, Shiva.
She was married to this place in Mamgachi, and she had a son, Vrindavan Das, and he was very, very dedicated devotee of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He wrote a scripture, Chaitanya Bhagavat, very, very famous. Maharaj also explained there a thing that he has written, that whoever does not accept Nityanand Prabhu, you put a lathi on his head. Then Maharaj explained, what does it mean? Yeah, bata Maharaj.
Explain.
Maharaj explained it.
Lati means this.
Acha, acha. Lati means that put your... kick him out. Kick, give a kick from your feet on his head. Why? Because if someone says that I believe in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and not any Guru and Vaishnava, then he is fit to be kicked. We should not spare him. Maharaj was explaining that devotional service cannot come only by avoiding Vaishnava or by doing criticizing Vaishnava and doing Vaishnava aparad. We have to be very much dedicated to Vaishnava and Guru. Only then we can gain bhakti. Only by worshipping Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or only worshipping Radha Krishna and not giving honor, respect and love to Vaishnava and Guru, we cannot get anything. What we'll get? We'll get a kick only.
That Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has told us to follow the slok Trina Dapi Sunichena Tarorapi Sahishnuna Amanina Manadena Kirtaniya Sadahari. But if anyone is criticizing my Gurudev, any Vaishnava, Krishna, Mahaprabhu, Nityananda, then what should we do? We should be Trinadapi Sunech and we should try to tolerate. But he is telling, no, don't tolerate. If you are tolerating, that it means you have no actual bhakti. You have no relation of Guru, Vaishnava and Hari. So at that time, what we should do? We should try to follow Hanuman. As Raman took away Sita from Ram, and when Hanuman knew, he burnt whole golden Lanka into ashes. So he is Trinadapi Sunich. So we should also try to follow. If anyone criticizing chest Vaishnav, Hari, Guru, Vaishnava, Guru, Bhagavat, Krishna, or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we should not be idle or tolerate it. If you have some
strength,
we should try to what? Give a slap or try to cut his tongue. And if you have so much Siddhant, you should try to
defeat them
so that he cannot speak anything. And if you have not so strong, then you should try to give up this place having your
closing your ears,
keeping like this,
running,
and run away from there, that place, and take bath in Ganges or anywhere with cloths. And always chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Otherwise you will be fall, and it will be like any offense for you if you are not doing. So we should be always careful for this, that we should not criticize any Vaishnava. We should not hear also that criticize. If you want bhakti, and if you don't want bhakti, you can do as you like. But if you want bhakti, then don't criticize any Vaishnava. Don't do ninda. Don't do any offense. Try to serve them according to their qualifications. Then bhakti will come and our life will be successful. Gaur Premanande. Tomorrow in the morning, very morning, we are going to Mayapur, the birthplace of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We'll cross the Ganges and first we will go to the place Nandana Acharya. Nandana Acharya, you know, Nandanandana Acharya, where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu first met with Nityananda Prabhu. There we will go. And how they met together and what was their modes at that time will express there. After that, we will go to Mayapur. But another party goes there before us, so we'll go to first Shivasangan, Advait Bhavan, Gadadhar Bhavan. The Shivasangan is the Ras Kirtan Rasasthali of Navadvip. In Vrindavan there is a Rasasthali of Krishna and Gopis, and here Kirtan Rasasthali is Shivasangan. And from there we will go to Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Samadhi place, and we will glorify him. We will also glorify his all disciples who served Srila Prabhupada. There our Gurudev has given Samadhi to Srila Prabhupada. As I gave Samadhi to Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj,
yes, your Guru gave.
Yes, our Gurudev gave Samadhi. At first, some devotees, some disciples, they wanted to burn Prabhupada's body, but my Gurudev objected. And he told, as I am living, anyone cannot do this. We will not burn it. We will give Samadhi in Mayapur near Chaitanya Mahaprabhu birthplace. So his body was taken from Calcutta to Mayapur and Guru Maharaj gave him Samadhi. There we will go. Then we will go to Chandrasekhar Bhavan. Chandrasekhar Bhavan Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, from where Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada spread his mission to whole world. After that, we will go Chandakaji Samadhi. Then we will go to Srimulya Gram. Jagannath is there. And Sridhar Angan. Sridhar Angan, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Always false quarreling with him. Prem Kalah, you know? Prem Kalah?
Loveful fight.
Huh?
Loveful fight.
Loveful fight with Siddhar. And then we will take prasadam there on the bank of Gaur Pond, Gaur Kunda nearby. And then we will return. So you should try to be there. Especially, we think that when we give Khichdi Prasad to all, in the last, management becomes false, fails. And some villager comes and they used to loot everything Khichdi. So I want that so big, strong person should be there for watch. So I have selected some persons that when the khichdi distribution will be there, some persons will be there. I declare the name and they should always be present there. In Western devotees, Ram Vijay. No? Brajanath Prabhu, Gopinath Prabhu, Nanda Kishore, and Govinda Bhakat, who is Pitambar Prabhu? Yes. Urukram Prabhu, Madhukar, or yourself, what is your name?
Radha Kanta.
And so strong persons should be watchmen there near
that place. They should barricade.
Yes, the kitchen room, so that anyone should not enter. Only the distributors should come there and no other person should enter there.
So what I name have given, or others also may be available at all time there. And you should try to be together and do a kirtan party there. You can also distribute Mahaprasadam, Nohar. So you should try to serve in all these things. Gaur Premanande.
You meet me there?
Yes, tomorrow, yes. No problem. I'll wait you. When you pass, I join you.
Yes.
I'm waiting for this since many days.
When we will pass, you should meet.
Yes. And Devi also, and I'm sure many devotees are going to come also.
Yes, that's
right. I'm looking forward
to it.
Now you can go and see Aarti Darshan and everything.